From the Mumbai studios of Republic TV, it's time for Arnab Goswami on The Debate.
Will have to be presented about the reality of the drugs business in Bollywood. And as someone leading the Republic Network, it is my utmost responsibility to expose this muck. And I intend to do so with the freedom my constitution gives me and the professional judgment we have acquired as journalists through hard work, detailed field investigations, chasing sources, uncovering new details, and viewers at every step in the last 100 days and more, we have been proven right. And viewers, you know that at every step, our enemies, they're enemies of the truth. They use everything possible to block us, but they fail, and they are bound to fail. Because two things are on our side: the truth, the pursuit of the truth, and national interest. They are both on our side. Viewers of The Debate, Pakistan and China benefit and have a direct role in the narcotics and narco-terrorism business. Unlike the drugs mafia in Bollywood, which is willing to overlook the threat to national interest to make money, the threat to national interest because of the drugs trade, we cannot and we will not. Drugs eat into our society. Drugs erode our younger generations, and rationalizing drugs is playing into enemy hands. Shraddha Kapoor, Sara Ali Khan, Deepika Padukone, now people working with Karan Johar, one of whom has been evasive before the Narcotics Control Bureau. I'm getting breaking news in the course of this broadcast that he's been detained after interrogation. But beyond all this, also an entire company, which is multiple companies under it, a labyrinth called Quan, deep into the drugs business. A company that represents topmost stars. And with the prospect of bigger names coming out, these people are becoming nervous. They should be. Because it is evident to all. And listen to me, Bollywood, participate in this cleansing. Denial will not help you. And to those wasted assets who think that they can block our journalism, come, I'm ready. I will fight you. I will fight the drug supporters everywhere, in every forum. But most importantly, you fight me, and I will fight you among the people of this country. Come, let's fight. Let the fight begin. Because out of this fight, there shall be the churn. And that's debate number one, drug company Quan. Debate number one, debate number two this evening. In some time, I have the lawyer for Sushant Singh Rajput's family live on The Debate. Stunning allegations. Debate number two this evening. Sushant's family fears interference in the results of the autopsy. We'll talk about that, and here are the headlines this Friday evening on The Debate Tonight.
So, to simplify it for our viewers, and they were part of this very WhatsApp group, and all the chats that we have narrated so far that took place, right from, you know, procuring of drugs to delivering of drugs.
The Republic Network exposes the drug company Quan. Its top bosses were on the drug chat group with Deepika Padukone. Drug company Quan, debate number one. And amid sensational details, it's official now. Bollywood drug company Quan bosses supplied drugs to top stars. Four-part expose on The Debate Tonight.
Karan Johar ke beech mein क्या करण जोहर के साथ और भी एक्ट्रेस थी क्षितिज, एक बार कम से कम चेहरा तो दिखाइए, अपना चेहरा क्यों छुपा रहे।
Two of his closest aides have been grilled. Will Karan Johar be questioned by the NCB next? 10 p.m. on Saturday is the time given to Deepika Padukone. She will be 10 a.m. will be questioned by the NCB tomorrow.
Your doctor of AIIMS, seeing the picture himself, makes a statement that this is 200% death by strangulation, and not it can't be death of us. It can't be a suicidal death at all.
Did a top AIIMS doctor say it was 200% strangulation? If yes, why hasn't the murder charge been added yet? Had questions over the AIIMS reports. Sushant Singh Rajput's family believes the investigation is taking a different turn. Republic will continue to fight for justice in the case. And ladies and gentlemen, last night on the debate, I said that the Kwan Big Boss must be arrested. The Kwan Big Boss must be arrested. Tonight, I have more proof of their supply, involvement in drug supply. Republic tonight exposes through its SIT team how this drug company Kwan was officially into drug supply, the commercialization of drugs. Here's the proof, the undeniable proof, and then we debate.
Rakul Preet.
किस बारे में आपसे सवाल जवाब किए गए रकुल, बताइए एनसीबी ने आपसे क्या क्वेश्चन किया? रकुल एनसीबी ने आपसे क्या क्वेश्चन किया बताइए।
करण जोहर्स एड क्षितिज रवि प्रसाद।
क्षितिज, एक बार कम से कम चेहरा तो दिखाइए, अपना चेहरा क्यों छुपा रहे? क्या गलती की अपने चेहरा छुपा रहे? सुबह से हम आपको बता दें घर इनके घर पे रेड हो रही थी और अब क्षितिज प्रसाद को उठा लिया गया है, इनको एनसीबी लेके जाया जा रहा है।
Bollywood's dirty details are tumbling out, but it's Kwan, the talent company, that stands exposed by Republic TV.
37 WhatsApp conversations accessed by Republic Media Network. WhatsApp conversation that took place within a group that was created by Jaya Saha, the drug kingpin, and Deepika Padukone was an admin of this very group. What's even more shocking is that those drug chats were basically taking place between Deepika Padukone and her talent manager Karishma, that too in the presence of top bosses from Kwan.
Expose one on Kwan proves that its bosses were aware of the drug deals. Take a look at Expose 2, the chats of Deepika Padukone and her 2017 free drinks invite. These chats show drugs were sought and delivered allegedly by drug company Kwan. Expose 3 and 4 on Jaya Saha's chats with Shraddha Kapoor and Nandita Sachdev say it all.
These chats are also with other celebrities, like for instance Shraddha Kapoor, with celebrity talent managers, and it becomes very crystal clear that the talent managers, they were essentially, what they were doing was not only looking after the celebrities' schedule, not only looking after their shoot, also looking at brand endorsements. The charter goes way beyond that.
This is the Kwan web tonight. Bosses at Kwan, stars managed by Kwan, and the drugs they supplied, it's all out in the open. Now that we know Kwan was a drug company, should its real boss be arrested? Let's debate.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, the debate is on drug company Kwan. And before I begin the debate, I want to tell you this, that this is not just about drug company Kwan. It is about what Bollywood has unfortunately become. Was Bollywood always like this? No. Were there druggies in Bollywood? Yes. But did the drugs culture enter Bollywood so deeply before? No. Was it entrenched before? No. Was the drug culture corporatized within Bollywood? No. Institutionalized within Bollywood? No. And Rakesh Bedi and Mukesh Rishi know what I'm talking about. That it was not as if before, if you were not part of a drug ring, you could not have any power play in Bollywood. Now drugs are used to reinforce power play in Bollywood. which is why I believe that it is extremely important to go to the bottom of this drug company Quan. The moment we go into the bottom of the drug company Quan, then we will unravel what really is going on in Bollywood. And to those people, I've been seeing some people who say, oh, we worked so hard to enter this industry. And now why are people questioning it? Well, if you worked hard to enter the industry, then you should support people questioning it. I'm talking about people like Manoj Bajpai. If you work so hard to enter it, then it is your responsibility to fight the rot, not defend the rot. Otherwise, people will rightly assume that because you entered it, you've made your place, you are willing to compromise ethics at the altar of keeping your place firm. And hence, today, I wanted to start by saying that disrupt it. So if Shailendra Singh knows things about it, Akashdeep knows, or today, Sherilyn is with me today, Sherilyn Chopra knows, she's made some claims, or if Rahul Ishwar knows, or if Yuvraj Singh is going to join us knows, or Swagata Shah, if she knows, we must talk about what's going on in Bollywood rather than defend it. So, pehle main shuru karna chahunga Rakesh Bedi ji se. Ye Rakesh Bedi ji, aap isko dekh rahe hain, you're watching this from a distance. Is it not time to call out the reality rather than defend those who are in this? Expose them, throw them out, let there be a Swachh Bharat Bollywood campaign also.
You see, I am feeling now it's not happening for real. I feel it's not happening for real.
Why?
Mujhe lag raha hai ki kuch ek ajeeb sa drama chal raha hai jo maine apni zindagi mein pehle kabhi nahi dekha. You know, I remember when we were doing a lot of films at that time, these agencies never existed. And frankly speaking, I have not heard the name of Quan till around 2 years back. I had never heard it because now it has become imperative for every actor who wants to become a hero or a heroine or somebody, a big star. He has to go into the shelter of some big agency. Otherwise, you don't get work. अभी उल्टा हो गया है. पहले जमाने में एक्टर डिसाइड करता था उसको क्या करना है. अभी एजेंसी डिसाइड करती है कि एक्टर को क्या पहनना है, कहाँ जाना है, कौन सी फिल्म करनी है. मैंने ये भी सुना है कि एजेंसी स्क्रिप्ट पढ़ के डिसाइड करती है कि एक्टर को ये फिल्म करनी चाहिए कि नहीं करनी चाहिए. दिस इज द काइंड ऑफ इन्फ्लुएंस सर्टन एजेंसीज आर हैविंग ओवर द एक्टर्स. वेदर ड्रग है या नहीं है, दैट आई डोंट नो बिकॉज आई बीन हियरिंग इट. अगर है तो आई एम वेरी सैड अबाउट इट. बट ये इन्फ्लुएंस ऐसा है इन एजेंसीज का, बिकॉज़ दे मेक द पाथ फॉर यू.
राकेश जी और एक सवाल मैं करना चाहूंगा. जैसे आपको मैंने आपके करियर को हम सब ने ट्रैक किया है. मुझे अभी भी याद है, स्कूल में अच्छा करते थे तो आपके सीरियल हमको देखने देते थे घर में. ऐसे आप लोग से लोगों को हमने देखा है और टैलेंट के थ्रू आप लोग सामने आए हैं, आप हो या मुकेश ऋषि हो. मगर क्या ये सच है कि आज अगर मुकेश जी आप खुलकर बोलिए, आज अगर आप इस सर्किट में नहीं घुसते जिसमें ड्रग्स वगैरह बहुत कुछ खुलेआम चलता है तो अच्छे रोल्स भी नहीं मिलते हैं. इसलिए मैंने बहुत बार देखा है कि बड़े बड़े अच्छे अच्छे एक्टर्स हैं जो बहुत टैलेंटेड हैं मगर वो उनको फ्रंटलाइन रोल्स नहीं मिलते हैं. बिफोर आई टॉक अबाउट ड्रग कंपनी क्वान, इज दिस ऑल्सो नॉट अ रियलिटी मुकेश ऋषि?
ये सरप्राइजिंग है कि क्वान एजेंसी का ये काम नहीं है. उसका काम है बिजनेस को मैनेज करना, एक्टर को मैनेज करना, उसके कैरियर को मैनेज करना. ये सप्लाई मेरी समझ से बिल्कुल बाहर है और बहुत तकलीफ दे है. एक तो वैसे ही बॉलीवुड कॉर्नर हो गया है,
शेप,
और उसकी सफाई सामने बिल्कुल नहीं आ रही. ये बहुत पेनफुल है. और ऊपर से कौन इनका मतलब समझ में नहीं आ रहा क्या किया जाए. और हम कभी भी ऐसी एसोसिएशन या ऐसी पार्टी का कभी हिस्सा रहे ही नहीं. वहां ड्रिंक होते थे, सिगरेट पिया जाता था, ये बात समझ में आती है. लेकिन मैंने कभी किसी को देखा नहीं. अगर किसी ने लिया भी होगा तो चोरी से कहीं जाके लिया होगा. लेकिन ड्रग्स की बात तो कभी अपनी जिंदगी में अपने को समझ में नहीं आई. क्योंकि मैं फिजिकल पर्सन, स्पोर्ट्समैन, मैं नेशनल लेवल का नहीं हूं. लेकिन मेरी सारी जिंदगी का जो रख रखाव है, टोटली डिसिप्लिन ऑन माय फिजिकल पार्ट. इसलिए मैं इस बात की बहुत रिस्पेक्ट करता हूं कि क्यों ये सब हो रहा है, क्यों समझ में नहीं आ रहा. और अगर इतना कुछ हो गया है वो क्यों सामने लोग क्यों नहीं आ रहे उसे ठीक करने के लिए
और उसको बचाया क्यों जा रहे हैं मुकेश जी? सबसे बड़ी बात यह है कि मैंने सोचा था मुकेश जी, मैंने सोचा था मैं अब बोल बोलिए मुकेश जी, अब मुकेश जी को बात खत्म करने दे पहले, लेट हिम फिनिश, लेट हिम फिनिश।
सर मैं ये कह रहा हूँ कि हमारी बहुत सारी चीजें अभी भी सही हो सकती हैं और मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि जिस तरह के इल्जाम लग रहे हैं उस तरह की पार्टिसिपेशन एक्टरों की तरफ से नहीं हो रही है, ये बहुत गलत बात है क्योंकि सारी बॉलीवुड ये काम नहीं करता। बहुतों को तो मालूम भी नहीं है ड्रग्स किस तरह के हैं, कितने नाम के हैं, ये क्या चीजें, हमें सब पता ही नहीं इन बातों का, तो वो क्यों कमी है मेरी समझ में नहीं आ रहा। और एड ऑन जो हो रहा है एक्टरों की लाइफ में, अब कौन का क्या काम है इसकी, ड्रग्स कैसे सप्लाई करेगा वो, ये उसके लिए उनका ध्यान रखेगा, ये तो हमें भी समझ में आता है। हॉलीवुड में ध्यान रखते हैं कि आपको अपना वेट मेंटेन करके रखना है, आपको अपनी सोशल लाइफ को मेंटेन करके रखना है, ये सब वो काम करती है वहां की एजेंसी। लेकिन ये जो काम ये हमारी समझ में नहीं है सर, ये बहुत ही पेनफुल है
What is more surprising is, as I am coming out with more evidence, I actually thought Shailendra and Shailendra and, you know, Akash, on one side, I thought Shailendra that beyond the point this industry will come out and understand that all the exposés that I am doing are aimed at cleansing it. Okay. Not being an abject denial about it. Now, one minute. But I am getting suspicious now. Because now I am told the so-called people, the top A-listers will come together. Oh, they want to stop Republic from reporting. I say come together. The whole country will know then who is the drug supporter. If they come together, they will identify themselves as drug supporters before the entire country. My question is now, Akashdeep and Shailendra, look how serious this is, and Sherlyn and Swagata, Shikha, all are free to come in. I want to tell you, there is a WhatsApp group. Now, don't tell me where I got this information. It's called DP plus KA plus Kwan. Now, I have my contacts, Shailendra. I have contacts everywhere. Agencies everywhere, investigating agencies everywhere. According to my information, my special investigation team has told me that Vijay Subramaniam, Anirban Das Bla, Madhu Mantena, as well as the Kwan CEO, a person called Dhruv Chitgopekar, they were all members of this group. And in this group, they were discussing the drug peddling. So my question is, Sherlyn can discuss this further with Shailendra. Why was the company's business model around drugs? Why is the CEO of the company, producer, shareholders, stakeholders, Sherlyn, yes, why are they into managing the drug supply? Secondly, there are chats of Jaya Saha with Shraddha Kapoor, where she is saying, this is your supply of drugs for the week. Sherlyn, please listen. Where Jaya Saha is telling Shraddha Kapoor, here is your week's supply. Here is next week's supply. I will today send you hash. Tomorrow I'll send you CBD oil. Day after tomorrow I'll send you something else. Wow. Why? Now, Jaya Saha is a partner of Kwan. Why is this happening? I just don't understand. Shailendra and then Sherlyn. Okay, Sherlyn wants to speak first. Sherlyn, yeah. Sherlyn first, yeah. Okay, everyone's on. But one after the other.
I was under the impression that Anirban was a genuine talent manager as he was representing Deepika Padukone. I had gone to his office a couple of years ago, and upon interacting with him, I realized that he is actually nothing more than a pimp. The first thing that he asked me was, are your breasts for real? But by the way, what's the cup size? Can I touch your breasts? These were the things that he said to me. And I told him, are you high? Are you high? Pagal ho kya? Ye koi tarika hai baat karne ka?
Shocking.
And he says, are aap to bura maan gaye. I said, ye bura maanne wali baat hai. Aap pagal ho? Kya aap Deepika ke saath aise baat karte ho?
Shocking.
And he says, अरे नहीं नहीं आप बुरा मान रहे हो, आप इतना क्यों overreact कर रहे हो? Overreact? Is this called overreaction? आप talent manager हो या आप pimp हो? पहले आप ये clarify करो.
Not at all.
अरे What relevance Arnab,
it's game over for Kwan in Bollywood.
Have with my career or with my future? You should be asking me.
But let's go back to the drugs issue, Sherlyn. My question was on the drugs issue, Sherlyn. On the issue of drugs. Yeah. If that is what Mr. Blah did with you, it is just unpardonable. I'm really sorry you had to go through such an experience. My point, however, is while I'm not discounting, you know, the trauma that you may have experienced at that time, Sherlyn, my question was, Shailendra, that this, I am horrified.
Yeah.
We seek no empathy or sympathy from people who are vested interests, but you know this, that whatever we are doing is cleaning up Bollywood. If Bollywood wants to fight me, if these people from Bollywood want to say they want to stop Republic from reporting, Shailendra, they can't stop me from reporting. Today we are in a situation where Karan Johar's right-hand man may be arrested. I'm breaking this news. We'll go to a reporter in a minute. One minute, Shailendra, let's understand how big this is. Karan Johar's right-hand man has been detained. Let us understand, first of all, today, Rakesh Bedi ji, ye kitna bada ho raha hai. Karan Johar ke jo bilkul dahine haath hai, Kshitij, unhone evasive the NCB ke saamne, unko detain kiya gaya hai, unko custody mein liya gaya hai, abhi formal arrest nahi hua hai, formal arrest bhi ho sakta hai. तो ये जो लोग सोच रहे रिपब्लिक को रोको, रिपब्लिक को मत रोको, अपनी सच्चाई गिरेबान में जाके देखो कि आज अगर करण जोहर का राइट हैंड आदमी उसकी गिरफ्तारी हो गई, शैलेंद्र अंडरस्टैंड इट्स अ सुनामी दैट सिटिंग बॉलीवुड एंड बॉलीवुड थिंक्स दैट इट्स गोइंग टू स्टैंड विद अ रेनकोट एंड प्रोटेक्ट इटसेल्फ फ्रॉम गेटिंग वेट इन द सुनामी. शैलेंद्र,
करेक्ट,
वी विल गो टू अ लाइव एज वेल.
Arnab, I just want to say something. First of all, Arnab, my heart bleeds at the facts that you've been putting out, I think, for more than a couple of months. Nobody is understanding how badly the operations of Bollywood are looking to the entire world. It's the entire world consumes and appreciates and salutes our Bollywood. So first of all, hats off to all your investigation. But what really shocks me, Arnab, I produced 70-odd movies. I've run a talent company for 2 decades, Arnab. I'm so disgusted at what is happening currently. But what surprises me, Arnab, is there are huge voices in Bollywood. There are good ambassadors, people, big talent. I mean, Salman Khan, Amitabh Bachchan, there are big superstars. This is their moment to speak up.
Oh,
this
no,
is their
quiet.
Moment. You're doing your job. Your crew is doing your job.
Yeah.
You're doing investigative journalism and ensuring that everybody who's guilty is taken to the task. But why aren't the people who are earning from Bollywood, from talent agencies, not getting out there? Today, I'm on your show for only one reason. My life has been Indian entertainment, Indian cinema, talent management, sports marketing. This is disgusting. This has to be cleaned up. And I swear, people like me are not so famous, but there are so many famous people who are correct and who have actually towed the line. Why the hell are they not speaking up? Why are they not taking responsibility of ensuring that their good voices are heard?
On the contrary, on the contrary, on the contrary,
as well as me, that these people will never speak up.
Why? Why won't they?
They will never speak up.
Why won't they?
I have told Arnab so many times I cannot defend this statement.
They
just don't come out even at crucial moments like this.
They have to speak up. No.
No, no, what are you saying? Tomorrow the Narcotics Control Bureau is going to be interrogating
these big stars. They have to, I know, but they don't, you know.
They won't speak up.
You know it, they won't.
There is one approach to there is, Akash, there is one approach to be investigated by the law. The other approach is to be upfront. If you are correct, if you really believe in this industry, stand up now. Or else forever forget about it, because this is real. What Republic TV has done has shown the truth
Shailendra,
to the entire
country. Shailendra, let me say this on Arnab's show.
This is the time for the ambassador of the entertainment industry to stand up.
Shailendra, let me say this on Arnab's show. Behind the scenes, I have tried speaking to everyone that, buddies, this is the time to speak. We've lost one of our brothers. Come on a collective platform and at least say you want justice. Nobody speaks, Shailendra. You know this as good as well as me. They just hide.
Yeah.
I told them, who am I? I'm a small little fish. How long will I defend Bollywood? Now I cannot defend.
Akash,
and Kwan,
Akash,
for me, Kwan, it's
Akash,
over. It's game over.
Akash,
shame on them.
Akash, is not about you and me. It's about the future of our country.
We cannot eliminate entertainment.
Yes.
We cannot eliminate talent management, sports
yes.
marketing, movies. We can't. We have to clean it up. This is a massive industry. But all these people who made
But it's an industry. But isn't it an industry? Like we say this, it's an industry, like we say about the news business. You may like or dislike, but we always say that the news business survives on the axiom of credibility. And we have seen, for example, networks when they supported people after the Radia tape scam, they lost all credibility. Credibility gone, you don't have anything left. Similarly,
yes. Yes.
In the film industry, or what you call is the entertainment industry, credibility matters, but you cannot,
yep.
I want Shikha to come in on this, you cannot take your fan base for granted.
Yes.
The point is that today I am proving out, you can't,
no,
if they want to make, no, Akash, one more, if they want to make Republic the enemy, okay? I am showing you that Jaya Saha and Kwan are having deals. I am showing you that there are commercial drug operations of Kwan percolating every layer. I am doing my job as a journalist. Top bosses like Dhruv to the new leadership that was inducted by Jaya Saha to all the employees like Karishma Saha, all have become peddlers. I am doing my job. I am proving it. I am showing that there was a drug nexus which was operating. Right? I am asking who is their investor, who is their supplier, who is their enabler. I am doing my job as a journalist. But where are the people who made their entire careers out of the fan base, Shikha? Their fans are asking them today.
I used to say some few Bollywood actors take, they should be punished.
That the people, please listen, sir.
You know what I was saying?
Please do not interrupt. Let me speak.
Say, okay, punish them.
Kindly follow the decorum, sir. Let me speak. Let me speak.
The sector of Kwan supplying, we need to hang our heads in shame. Please.
Arnab, what I want to say about you and the channel, that the people have this misconception that you're doing this for your personal benefit. Let me say, कि मीडिया का काम उजागर करना होता है इट्स योर चॉइस टू बी एक्सपोज्ड और टू बी अप्रिशिएटेड विद ऑल योर कर्मास सबसे पहली चीज दूसरी बात मेरा खुद का एक्सपीरियंस एक नवोदित अभिनेत्री होते हुए व्हेन माय डेब्यू फीचर फिल्म कांचली केम इन सेवन ऑन 7th February मैं बहुत लंबे समय से क्वांस में अपने आप को रजिस्टर करना चाहती थी मुझे लगा मेरी डेब्यू फिल्म आ गई मैं जा सकती हूँ विद लॉट्स ऑफ टैलेंट बट दे मेड मी फील आउटडेटेड बिकॉज आई डोंट पार्टी आई डोंट ड्रिंक आई डोंट स्मोक आई डोंट डू ड्रग्स जी
Who is they?
So definitely I say they are not the talent managers. They are definitely the drug managers which we are seeing right now. That's the truth. I have experienced this. They definitely filter you, seeing your nature, observe you that, oh, this girl, this is simple. She's simple. She talks about talent. No, that's bullshit. Talent is not appreciated. Who wants talent? टैलेंट से क्या होता है उसके अलावा बहुत कुछ चाहिए सो व्हाट इज दैट अलावा वो जो टैलेंट के अलावा जो होता है वो दुनिया के सामने आ रहा है और हम जिन लोगों को देखकर इंडस्ट्री में आए हैं वो है मुकेश जी राकेश जी एंड थैंक गॉड दे आर स्पीकिंग दे आर टेकिंग देयर स्टैंड
थैंक गॉड फॉर
द पीपल हु हैव बीन आइकन फ्रॉम इयर्स जिसमें बच्चन साहब हैं जिसमें और बड़े बड़े नाम हैं जिनका नाम अभी शैलेंद्र जी ले रहे थे जिनका नाम अभी सब ले रहे थे दे हैवंट स्पीक दे हैवंट स्पोक अ सिंगल वर्ड व्हेन वी लॉस्ट सुशांत सिंह राजपूत जब उन्हें किसी के मरने पर फर्क नहीं पड़ा तो आपको लगता है कि उन्हें ड्रग्स में
जहां
पर उन्हें फर्क पड़ेगा दे कांट स्पीक
Absolutely.
Such an important issue. You have to
speak. No. Absolutely. And Shikha. Rahul, can I tell you one thing? See, why do people not speak? Let me take it from there. Akash, 1 minute. And I know many of them watch my program. I appeal to you. I am telling all the Bollywood people out there. You want to fight me, you want to fight Republic, I will fight you. I will fight you in courts, among the people, wherever I will fight you. Because you cannot defend something that is indefensible and get away with it. I am making a public statement today, Yuvraj, because I know they want to fight me.
Yeah.
I will fight them. I have the people of the country on my side. But when I will fight you, I will name you.
Yes.
I will name you on air.
I will expose you and fight you.
Now fight to me. My question is, I can't be stopped on this anymore. I don't care. I have seen what is beyond, as they say, I beyond the mountaintop, I know what's there. The truth will come out. My question is not that. My question is today. And please don't take it otherwise, Mr. Bachchan. But Mr. Bachchan, didn't you know? Don't all the big names of Bollywood, don't they know what's going on? I am an outsider. I don't even know anything about Bollywood. But the people who are working in Bollywood, whose children are in Bollywood, whose fathers are in Bollywood, whose friends are in, don't they know what's going on? Tell me, Yuvraj, if the drug nexus was operating with Kwan as the fulcrum.
Would they not know? They know it for too long, actually. And unfortunately, their children are now in the, you know, in the tapes, in the videos. They're getting all viral. And they have to give an answer. And as we all are saying in the industry, we all are industry people. We all are saying that, you know, they are just now running for it. And they don't have the guts to face it. No matter how big a star they are or, you know, what legacy they have. Suddenly the big truth of drugs, womanizing and even prostitution is exposed. You can't deny it. It's high time we have to accept it. We are putting the blame on corporate world. On China, on Bihar elections, blah, blah, blah. But that doesn't matter. The fact of the matter is, we are very much responsible for the situation of the industry right now. And the big stars, the big brands, the big names, the big agencies, they all are responsible for this muck. And they have to apologize to this nation.
You tell me today, Yuvraj, I don't know how this industry operates, frankly. You and Shailendra know.
Are these issues only in Bollywood?
Okay.
Are these issues only in Bollywood? Can he start it?
No.
Are these issues only in Bollywood? Yes, there is general issues that should be addressed. But let us not demonize Bollywood. People like Jaya Bachchan.
I am not demonizing Bollywood. I am talking about the reality of Bollywood, and I am asking you whether or not it is Jaya Bachchan's responsibility to speak up about this as well. I am talking about selective silence.
Why are they not coming out? Where is Farhan Akhtar? Where is Javed Akhtar? Where is Shabana Azmi? Where is Amitabh Bachchan?
Yeah, Bachchan, talk about this and said, let us not demonize.
No, where are they? Good question.
Punish those people who Fauzia. Have gone wrong.
And Fauzia is on the right. Fauzia, where are they? Where are these people? Fauzia, where are these people?
First of all, I would like to say, Arnabji, the job that you are doing, it was the job of NCD. Secondly, I want to know that what is the root? Where is the root of these drugs? Why are we not talking about this? Why are we silent about that? You are asking somebody, I just don't remember the name, asking that where Shabana Azmi and these people. You question them, they will definitely tell you where they should they. What is the place that they should come and speak about it. So what is the root? Where is the root?
I turn that question around. Sherilyn wants to come into debate with you. One minute. I'll tell you the root. There is no secret. One second. Fauzia, the root is Pakistan and China. I also want to tell you one more thing. Sherilyn can validate it for me. If you allow me a minute, I'll tell you. You see, Fauzia, one, the root is Pakistan. Second route, which is now emerging, is China. And the most favorite drug in Bollywood circles used to be a drug called MD. Now, MD has been replaced with a drug called China White. China White is a synthetic drug manufactured in China. Second point, China White has been brought in through Bollywood and is now considered among the most popular drugs, synthetic drugs, in elite, so-called fake elite circles. The children of these Bollywood stars, you go and ask them, when they go for the rave parties, and you know there are videos doing the rounds of the children of the stars.
At the drug parties,
they are using China these White. So my point is, the root is China. China is India's enemy. By allowing such drugs to infiltrate, Bollywood is helping China and Pakistan.
This is the failure of our system.
Who is failure of our system. Sherlin wants to say something. Sherlin, yeah. Let Sherlin come in. Yuvraj, let Sherlin come in.
When we come forward and talk about the dirt and the drug cartel in Bollywood, the supporters of the Nashedi gang, they say, "Arey, why are you blaming the consumers? Go catch hold of the manufacturers and suppliers. Why are you blaming the consumers? Consumer ko to maal milta hai supplier se, manufacturer se, to jao unko pakdo." Now, what kind of a defense is this?
No.
What kind of a defense is this?
It's not defense. It's a very valid question. That why are we not questioning the system?
Are you supporting the Nashedi gang? Are you supporting the Nashedi gang?
Is it not the
No.
Fair?
No, what does this mean? Why blame the consumers? Why not blame the consumers? Don't we have a moral and social responsibility?
Mukesh, I would like, Sherlin, I want to bring in Mukesh Rishi and Rakesh Bedi also. Mukesh Rishi, Rakesh Bedi on the left, and I would like to have Shailendra and all on the right. My question is, Rakesh Bedi, today the defense of Bollywood is, go ask the people how the drugs entered our country. Now, I feel that that's a facetious question. That's a foolish question, because you are the consumers. If today the drug peddlers, the drugs mafia is able to manage Bollywood, Rakesh Bedi, then they can manage our younger generation. And then these Bollywood people become the talent managers. They organize the events. They spread the drugs. The drugs enters through the entertainment industry in this country. Rakesh Bedi, are people not understanding the simple fact that if you can control the entertainment industry, then it's a sure shot way to bring drugs into every generation and every layer of India? Rakesh ji.
Yeah, I agree to it, but there's also one thing which we are forgetting, that the drugs have been there in Punjab. Today, younger generation of Punjab, on which Udta Punjab was made, the film was made, you know, the younger generation is almost eradicated. They are all into drugs. 90% of the people are into drugs, and of course, the drug cartels are there, drug people are there, and now this is another channel.
Sir Saji doesn't agree.
Because what happens is, they are very smart. What I'm saying is that agar samjho ki yahan par stars ko ye lagta hai ki hum agar who doesn't agree,
it's okay, let the debate continue. Yeah, continue, Rakesh, continue.
Sirsa ji,
what I'm saying is ki ab ye drug cartels jo hain, they can find their own ways and means. It's a big mafia. It's very difficult to control them, and we know it. You know, we have seen Escobars all over the world. So once they decide कि यहाँ पर हमको ड्रग को इन्फिल्ट्रेट करना है, तो उसके बाद उनको वेज एंड
नो सो देन इज इट नॉट द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी राकेश जी, एंड आई वांट टू आस्क मुकेश एंड शैलेंद्र दिस, द स्मॉल फ्राई आर नॉट बीइंग स्पेयर्ड. जो बड़ी मछली है मुकेश जी, वो चुप क्यों है? आज करण जौहर के दाहिने हाथ क्षितिज की इंटरोगेशन चल रही है 8.5 घंटे से, तो क्या आज अमिताभ बच्चन जी चुप रहेंगे इस पर? आज भी रणबीर कपूर चुप क्यों है? ऋतिक रोशन, सोनम कपूर, टाइगर श्रॉफ, जैकुलिन फर्नांडिस, ये सारे लोग आज चुप क्यों हैं? जो ए लिस्टर्स सारे क्वान पे क्यों जाते हैं? क्या क्वान के सारे क्लाइंट की अभी डोप टेस्ट होनी चाहिए? अब जया बच्चन जी चुप क्यों हैं? इज इट अ रॉन्ग क्वेश्चन, वाई आर जया बच्चन साइलेंट नाउ? इट इज प्रोवन, मुकेश ऋषि, दैट द इंडस्ट्री इज सोक्ड इन ड्रग्स. Multi-layered corporatization of drugs in Bollywood is a reality. Are we not going to speak about it now? Mukesh Rishi.
Sir, mera ek concern aur hai. Cinema ke baad jo TV ki jo generation hai, unki age bahut hi kam hai. Aur bahut successful hai wo bache. Agar ye fashion hai, to this is a very dangerous fashion for them also. Unka age kya hai? 24, 25, 27, और बहुत सारे लोग अपने पेरेंट्स के साथ नहीं रहते, अकेले रहते हैं, जो उनको कोई बताने वाला नहीं है कि उनको कौन सा रास्ता पकड़ना है या कौन सा नहीं पकड़ना है. वो जो लोग हैं वो सबसे बड़े विक्टिम होने वाले हैं इस चीज के ओवर द इयर्स, क्योंकि उनको समझ में आ गया कि ड्रेस चेंज करनी है एवरी नाइट पार्टी के लिए और नया ड्रेस पीना है जो सब में एक्सेप्टेड है. ये बहुत खतरनाक है. बाकी जो बड़ों की बात मैं कह रहा हूं सर, हम में कहीं मेरे अंदर एक इमोशनल बात करना चाहूंगा, मुझे थोड़ा सा टाइम दीजिए सर। मैं बॉलीवुड से बहुत प्यार करता हूं और मेरा एक इमोशनल टच है इसके लिए। मैं अभी भी कहता हूं कि जितने भी बच्चों के नाम आए हैं, मैं चाहता हूं आप सब जाओ और सब ड्रगिस्ट नहीं होंगे, उनमें से जो लोग वापिस आएंगे क्लियर करके मैं सबसे पहले उनके लिए ताली बजाऊंगा। ये मेरी फीलिंग है मेरे ड्रग्स के लिए। ये फैमिली है, जहां जाते हैं हम लोग, जो पाया जो मिला इनकी वजह से मिला हमने, इसको स्टॉप करना है। आप इसको फैमिली समझ लीजिए ना, किसी की भी बच्ची हो, उसी एज का बच्चा तो मेरा है, वो लड़की छोटी है उसी एज की लड़की मेरी है, मैं उस रूप में इसको देख रहा हूं।
मुकेश जी इसमें एक फर्क है, सॉरी टू इंटरप्ट यू, व्हाट यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड नाउ इज, वन मिनट, हमें आप लोग आप डिनायल में मत रहिए, बुरा ना माने, यू आर अ सीनियर मैन, बट डोंट माइंड माय सेइंग दिस, डोंट बी इन डिनायल। ये हमारी बच्चिए वाला सिस्टम नहीं चलेगा, क्योंकि ये आप अपने नजरिए से देख रहे हैं, वो आपकी बच्ची है क्योंकि वो बॉलीवुड की दीपिका पादुकोण बड़ी सितारा है, मगर उसने कितनों को इन्फ्लुएंस किया है। ये क्वान के लोग भी बोलेंगे, मुकेश ऋषि हम आपके बच्चे हैं, आप उनको बोलिए हम हमारे बच्चे नहीं है, आपने कॉर्पोरेटाइज कर दिया ड्रग कल्चर को। वन मोर पॉइंट आई वॉन्ट टू ब्रिंग, और आज की सच्चाई जो है, the truth about today, I want Yuvraj to tell you. Mukesh ji, I feel you are innocent in these matters, but let me tell you this. And feel free to come in Swagata Shah at any point if you want to. The point is, what we are seeing today is a model of operation to procure, distribute, transact and consume drugs in a well-oiled corporate system. It is planned, plotted, and it is a structured way of operation.
Very true.
It is not
very
just ki drugs de diya.
Do you agree with me,
Swagata?
Yes, Arnav, I completely agree with you. Because see, I have my circle which belongs to this industry. I've seen all the young beautiful girls who come from north, who come from south to make their career. They're very beautiful, they're very good looking, but it is just they get carried away. Then their parents get worried, they call them back. And there are a lot of stars who know exactly what they're doing. This is just the theory that drugs removes depression, drugs removes anxiety. It's not the solution. Lot of actors and lot of celebrities do drugs and come up with this theory that we work so hard, we get tired, we need energy to give a perfect shot, we need to be on drugs. This is their statements, and many times they have passed this statement in the closed circuit. I personally know, because there are a lot of people around me who keeps on sharing their experience, what they've gone through. There are a lot of people who are not coming up and telling all of this fact. There are a couple of celebrities who are flaunting this thing, and they are very, very much proud about it. They think that they will not get caught, and this is the time they have got caught now. That's why everyone is worried. A lot of celebrities and a lot of big personalities, A-listed personalities, are leaving India now. Why are they leaving? If they have not consumed anything, they should come up front. How Kangana spoke about it. Yeah, okay, you must have consumed once upon a time because of something, but now if you have left it completely, come up front and say about it. Let the youth also know that this thing is not at all good, because youth is following you. Youth wants to exactly be like you. Swagata.
What we need to understand is, what we need
Swagata,
to emphasize today is...
Rahul
and Yuvraj.
The approach is Anarji. Not of revenge. Mukesh ji said is the crux of the matter. What Mukesh ji said is the right approach. That approach is the most important aspect. These young stars
what
are not
are
born
talking
criminals.
About? You don't
they
know
are
what
people who got
about.
Influence.
Why don't
have
you debate with
Yuvraj?
Will tell you
the right approach.
Sherlin responding to Rahul Ishwar. Incorrigible Rahul Ishwar.
Seconds to speak, please.
Sherlin.
We are not shaming them. We are not calling them criminals. All I'm saying is, it's high time.
Sherlin.
That Deepika Padukone updates her slogan. Repeat after me, depression is an illness. No, repeat after me, I will not engage in drug abuse. Repeat after me, drug abuse leads to depression. Repeat after me, it is not cool, it is not okay to engage in narcotics. Repeat after me, I will not engage in drug consumption.
Repeat after me. I will not waste my life on drugs. This should be the new slogan. This should be the new mantra.
Once spoken and repeat after me. Drugs is a sickness is what Deepika should be tweeting. My point is, you see, what we need to point out, and I want to bring in Yuvraj once again. See, it's a big money operation. First of all, it's a big money operation. There's a lot of money. There is the corporatization of drugs. Quan partners are discussing drug deliveries. Deepika's manager has been questioned to identify payment models and peddler links. Now, what we understand is that certain hotels have become the hotbeds for drug parties. Rave parties are a big business, because I was told that a billing in an average Bollywood rave party can go up to upwards of 40 to 50 lakhs for one night, out of which maximum amount of the revenue is as a result of drug consumption. So we need to understand this. So point, Yuvraj, you need to make maybe that why does a company like Quan become a drug company? It may not have started as a drug company. It becomes a drug company because of money. The more the money, the more the influence, the more the cartel. I think we need to talk about how they work.
Yeah, I mean, they are just working like that. That's the way of their working. These parties are organized for film circulation. They claim to have script discussions over here. They claim to have having some kind of, you know, bonding over these drugs. And then the films are decided. Even the future of other
Yesterday you said on the program, but Shailendra had left by then. You said that these EDM music concerts which are held, and Shailendra is, you know, he has managed many of them organized. You said EDM music concerts. No. Are essentially rave parties, and a lot of them are held in Goa and Bombay. Why don't you confront Shailendra directly about it?
Let him speak.
Varun, Yuvraj, please speak.
And he knows what goes on there. And I don't want to say more, because many things have personally come on him. And I have huge respect for Shailendra Bhai, because he's been a top-notch producer in the industry. But, you know, he knows, at least he's accepting that there has been these mistakes that have happened in the industry. And, you know, that's what we have to learn.
Young children die of overdose at these music concerts? If nobody dies of overdose of music, Shailendra, what is the overdose they have died of?
Drugs.
Why do young people die of overdose in music concerts? I can listen to music all day, but I won't die of an overdose. Tell me the truth. What happens? Shailendra?
क्या मुझे अब मौका मिलेगा बोलने का?
हाँ, मौका दे रहा हूँ, बोलिए ना.
या अर्नब, can I? हाँ, दीजिए ना, मगर मौका तो दीजिए. मैं इंतजार करके, मतलब कितने वक्त से इंतजार कर रहा हूँ. तो कुछ बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट विषय हैं जिन पे बहुत पैनलिस्ट ने डिस्कस किया. तो पहले तो जो हमारे एनिमीज हैं, चाहे वो चाइना हो या पाकिस्तान हो, वो तो चाहेंगे कि हमारे
आई वॉन्टेड टू आस्क यू अबाउट नो नो व्हाट इज दिस सिंथेटिक म्यूजिक एंड सिंथेटिक ड्रग्स आर दे अ गुड कॉम्बिनेशन
और
Why do children die of overdose at EDM music events? Why do young Indians die of drug overdose at music events?
I mean, stop generalizing.
I'm not generalizing. I'm very specific. I'm concerned.
Stick to the point of discussion today.
I'm concerned. It is a point of discussion.
You cannot make accusations.
But I'm not making accusations. It's a reality. Yuvraj spoke about it. I'm asking you.
Yeah, so don't say that. 1 minute, let me explain to you. Live entertainment. There is classical music.
I'm sorry, I've run short of time. I'll take the debate forward another time, ladies and gentlemen. Many questions in my mind when I come back on the other side. The details of how Sushant could have been killed.